Volume. Okay, so good afternoon, everyone. So today's topic is discover your hidden potential. How many of you all want to really discover your hidden potential? Great. How many not? Everybody wants to, right? Awesome. So today's topic is really very interesting, in which you will really take home or really learn what is hidden potential, and how can we really take a look at it, and how can we really discover the hidden potential within ourselves, yeah, and use it to grow our lives in a very beautiful way. So before we begin the talk on this topic today, I would as usual and from the bottom of my heart would like to thank the Help Library and the staff and management of Help Library for making this opportunity available and giving me this platform to share my views. So thank you so much. And I would also like to thank you very much for being here on this hot and humid afternoon. So thank you very much for being participants in this talk. And to introduce myself, what gives me the authority to even talk about this? So this is again something, when I started on my journey of self, my journey of self-actualization, or my journey of finding my own self, that is when I started finding out my own hidden potential. So I am Rohini Gupta, and I am a NLP master practitioner and coach. I am also a counselor, and I am also learning a lot of things. I am a certified trainer and learning a lot of things from Success Gyan and their Quantum Leap program, which is again about discovering your hidden potential and really finding out what is it that you can really do and stretch, how much can you really stretch your own limits, and which is a very, very beautiful journey. And as always, I remain the student of life. So let us begin the journey of discovering our own hidden potential. So the title itself, what does it tell us? Discover your hidden potential. Discover. So something, yeah, so something which is covered and we need to discover, yeah, we need to find out, rightly said, sir. Hidden potential. So something which is hidden, which is within ourselves only, which is hidden. It is not that we have to derive it from somewhere. We don't have to acquire it from somewhere. It is the hidden potential that we have within. Yes. It is invisible, yeah, hidden, which is not visible to our own eyes. So what is the potential? Now what is the meaning of the word potential? Any suggestions? What do you mean by potential? Mm-hmm. To enhance the power, okay.
The strength
from within. So I have a few definitions about our potential from the lectures of Dr. Miles Monroe, which I really, really resonated with. So what is potential, he says? It is the dormant ability that we have. It is the untapped power. It is the hidden strength, as you said. It is the reserved energy. It is the unused success. It is the success, nevertheless, which is unused. It is the unleashed talent. It is all that you can do but haven't done yet. It is all that you can become but haven't become yet. Yeah? Can we all really agree with this, yeah, this point? Isn't it that, exactly. So whatever it is, an ability, it is something that I could have become but haven't become yet.
Everybody unknown.
Yeah.
Able to, but we don't know what to do or what.
Right.
Inside us.
Yeah, so thank you. Like you said, we don't know how to do it, and we don't even sometimes even believe this. So whatever we have done till now, it is not our potential. It is not that we have lived up to our potential. When we look at the universe, how many of you have seen a sunrise on a sunset? How many? Yeah? Everybody has seen a sunrise or a sunset. How many of you see this every day or frequently at least? Yeah, frequently. Yeah. So how many times the sunset is exact same? Exact same. There is a variation always.
No moon days, no moon, full moon day, no moon days. It's not like this, like this.
Yeah.
Only there's a eclipse occurring that time, so different, you know.
But even if the sunrise happens every day, even if you watch the sunrise every day or the sunset every day, is there a variation in that?
Yeah, yeah, right.
Yeah? So what
distance,
is the... Yeah.
Distance, that is.
Yeah.
Distance.
Yeah.
Inclines on the reason, you know, inclines.
Yeah, whatever it is, but it is always different, right?
Yeah.
So what is the universe teaching us? The universe itself is so creative. It keeps on reinventing itself and showing different colors every day. Is that right? And that is how we, which is a small particle of this universe, we are also made that way. So whatever we have done today is done. So today I click a picture of the sunset which happened yesterday evening, or today evening if I click a picture, that picture is old. The universe is never going to see me, so show me the exact same sunset again. Tomorrow there is going to be a new sunset, new colors, new variations in the clouds, new variations of the light, right? Everything is going to be new. So what is the universe showing us? That each of us also has the potential to show our new colors every day. Very difficult to believe, right? Yeah.
Every day is changing.
Hanji.
How to believe that tomorrow also that is coming is also potential.
See,
course,
yeah.
Every day you add yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Today, what is today,
mm-hmm,
not will not be tomorrow.
Right.
What is tomorrow will not be again.
That's true. So just
yeah,
the moment now, see this moment is not like a further moment.
Yeah.
See, what happened this moment, it will not occur in the same thing.
Right.
Same day or same things.
Exactly.
It is a various.
Yes. So why do we as people, don't we live the same lives every day? Every day don't we follow the same routine? And so many of us are stuck in the same jobs that we don't like. What do we do? What do we teach ourselves? What do we teach ourselves to do? That I need to grow up and take up some job. And every day, how do we go to our workplaces? I have to go for my work. If I don't, how will I earn the money? Right? So, what are we doing? Where is that creativity? That when we say, I have to do something, or I should do something, there is so much of heavy energy over there. As opposed to being excited in doing something. If I am excited, if the sunrise, see, for centuries, the sun has been rising every day and setting every day. For each part of the world, right? Whether we wake up in the morning or not, the sun will rise, right? Whether we sleep in the night or not, the sun will set in the evening. That is for sure. The sun doesn't say, oh, I have to. The sun keeps on showing so much creativity every day. Even on the cloudy days, the sun is still shining behind the clouds. And that is, yes, and then, yes, yes, and then we see those silver linings behind the clouds and we say that every cloud has a silver lining. So what does the universe do? Every day inspires us with its own creativity, right? So what can we learn from the universe here? That every day if we keep on reinventing ourselves, every day if we welcome the day, be really grateful for being alive. If we are able to really be grateful to start a new day, have a plan. Like the sun has a plan, right? It rises in the east, sets in the west, every day without fail. It doesn't drag on. It has no problems with whatever people call it. It does not matter to him on whom it is shining its light, irrespective of whoever it is on this earth gets the adequate light, द सन डजंट डू कंजूसी कि मैं इसको कम दूंगा, आई विल गिव लेस लाइट टू दिस पर्सन एंड आई विल गिव मोर लाइट टू दिस पर्सन प्रेजेज मी, दिस पर्सन डजंट लाइक मी. डज द सन डिस्क्रिमिनेट? द सन डज नॉट. And it keeps on reinventing and brightly shining every morning. Now, if we try to relate it to our own lives, how do we begin our days? Do we have a purpose in our lives? For what do we wake up? We wake up only with the intention of surviving most of the time.
And it is a body cycle,
Body cycle, so it has become like a routine. It has simply become a routine. Where is the excitement of being alive? Where is the excitement of being alive and creating? Each of us on this earth, we were born with a purpose. Each of us is unique in our own rights. However, how do we live our own lives? We feel we are born, then after a particular age, we go to school. We go through a particular education system, class 1 to 10 and then 12th and then graduation, whether the graduation has its value or not. What do we tell our children? You should do it because that is what you need to do. Basic graduation, is there a value of it? Engineering, even engineering doesn't have any value today. Right? And even when you are an engineer, when you go out in the field, you don't know what to do. Your education has in no way prepared you for the real life or the workplace. In the workplace, you have to undergo all the training one again.
Reinvention is a person, no? So
yeah.
That is what also the bygones.
Mm-hmm.
4-5 years, education is not there. Syllabus is not there.
Yes.
After 4 years or 3 years, it's changing. So that is your
Yes, life is practical and education is theoretical. Exactly. So no value in real life, right? So, and yet we teach our children to do the same. Why don't we allow our children to follow their passions? Right? Do we allow our children to follow their passions? Do we allow our children to grow in the fields they want to grow? That is also something we need to do. And how will we allow? Because our lives are trapped, so we want to trap our children's life. And we feel, oh, this is how the world is. When just ask a little child, what do you want to become? Every day the children keep on changing what they want to become when they grow up. One day they want to become pilots, one day they want to become scientists, one day they want to become something. Right?
What kind of market will you know that and see this world?
What kind of market, they have no idea.
They don't have any idea.
Exactly. They just want to do what they want to do. And it is people who have really done daydreaming are the ones who have created things. Yeah. Now, just imagine somebody would have just told Newton, what rubbish? What are you doing? Why are you wasting time in all these things? Such a waste of material. Such a waste of thing. What are you doing? Wasting things around the house, breaking things around the house? What is the need? Would we have all the gadgets that we have today? Would we have all anything that we have today if somebody had not dreamt about it? And had somebody not nurtured their dreams, or somebody had not followed their own dreams? And where did that come from? Till they achieved it, did they know it many a times? They didn't even know it. Once they achieved it, they discovered that this was their hidden potential. Right? So that is why the potential is generally something which is not yet revealed. So how else can we, like all the definitions that we just saw, how is, or sometimes when does the potential come forth? Sometimes it comes because of some inspiration, because of some dream that we have. And sometimes it comes out because of some desperation. Like there is one story narrated by Jim Rohn always, that there was a lady he encountered who was the vice president of a company. And he asked her, what is the secret behind your success? And she said, I was a homemaker. One day, I asked my husband for $10. And he asked me, what for? That day, that woman decided, nobody is ever going to ask me what for. I am going to become self-sufficient. Right? Do we know such things in our own families? Do we know such scenarios in our own families? That if a homemaker is at home, taking care of the home and the children, many times, this is a common dialogue. If she asks for money to the husband asks, yeah, it becomes like a begging thing for the woman. And she has to really, really kill her own self-esteem and ask. And then when the husband asks her, what for? It is really humiliating for any woman. Right? But out of that situation, this woman, she decided that I will never be in this position again. So this became the fuel for her to realize her own potential. Had this not happened, she would not have truly realized her own potential. She would not have determined something. She would not have taken action towards it. And that is all what we do many a times. And what do we say when we retire? Like, I really admire all of you that you are here and you really make that effort every day to learn and encourage people like me, whoever, like whomsoever comes here to share. You all come here and participate and really encourage and genuinely make an effort to learn also when you all are established in your own rights. So, which is really very admirable. But there are so many people. What do we decide? How is the path of our lives charted? We go to work, we work like donkeys, we save for future, we save for rainy days or whatever. We don't enjoy sometimes, sometimes we do, sometimes we don't enjoy when we have the money. And then we retire one day. Towards what are we working? One day I will retire. And what does retirement mean? Retirement means now I'm not going to work. And when you don't work, what are you waiting for? For death? When a person retires, when a person is not looking forward to do anything, that person is looking forward only to death, right? What are we doing? Waiting only towards death? Or can that be the time to truly live our own dreams? Discover what I can do. I know a gentleman whom I really admire. At the age of 65, he learned driving a car. Which is so admirable. So, when you are learning new things, and it is a proven fact that when you are reading, not on the magazines or reading on your mobiles or something, when you are physically reading a book, you are giving your imagination, you are firing your own imagination, and that actually increases one's longevity. Yes, absolutely. Yes.
Liberty to your memory.
Yes.
And what you are reading on a mobile now, it's wanted. That particular para is wanted for you. I mean, within that period you have to read. So
yes.
So that kind of tension is within 1 minute or 2 minutes, you have to read.
Yeah.
And here, a lot of time, you have a lot of time to create your own thoughts.
Yes.
Here also.
Absolutely.
Here, mobile is not. It's just like, it's killing your memory. It's what you're reading.
Yes, absolutely. So when you're actually reading, that is when you are really firing your own imagination. And there you can actually be in your own imagination. You can do, be, whatever you want to be or do. Right? And through that, there are so many. In fact, today, if you see the internet, if you want to see this, there are so many stories with a prosthetic leg or a prosthetic hand or in fact both the legs. People are running, people are cycling, people are doing all sorts of things. So, even a limitation of body part is no more a limitation anyway for people who don't want to have it. But for people who do not want to make an effort to even give oneself a chance, even when they are completely able-bodied, when they have everything that a perfect human being needs to have, every body part is fine, their mind is not functioning. Because they are limiting their minds with their own limiting beliefs.
Yeah. It is not mature.
Yes.
He should be guided by some elder one.
Sir, he should be guided, that is true. However, because the child is not mature, there are so many times we discover so many things through the child's eyes.
Because so long you teach the child.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Values is fine, sir. But limiting oneself. Now, let me tell you a story, okay? Since you brought this topic up, I'm just reminded of a story about a group of frogs, okay? So, this group of frogs, amongst themselves, they were having a competition. So, there's this huge pole and they were trying to climb the pole. Okay, now, let us say that the pole was about till the ceiling, and every frog, the maximum height any frog had climbed that particular pole was just here. Okay, so all the frogs would climb, and they knew that okay, they had also put a mark that okay, this is the point, beyond this generally we frogs can't go up. So everybody was trying. And then once some frogs would go only up to this height, some frogs only up to this height and come down, and they were generally content with it. Some younger hot-blooded frogs, enthusiastic frogs, they climbed up to the maximum height, and then again they would come down. Now there was one little frog amongst them. He started climbing, and he crossed this particular mark. He climbed higher, and everybody was shouting, "Stop, stop, little frog, you will fall down, little frog, you don't know, no frog has ever climbed higher than that, don't go up." They all started shouting, and the frog kept on climbing and climbing and climbing and climbing and climbing and reached the top. And everybody was shocked. They said, "All the frogs till now, it has never happened that the frogs have crossed this height. How did this little one climb that high?" Now everybody started looking. Now the frog was over there, up there, happy, and then he came down. So they asked him, "How did you do it? We were telling you, don't do it. Why did you still keep climbing? What if you had fallen down? You could have hurt yourself." But the frog did not answer. So they started looking for the parents. So the parents, all of a sudden, they came from somewhere, somebody came to know who are the parents and all, and the parents came over there. And the other frog said, "Do you know what your son did?" They said, "What did he do?" He said, "We were shouting at him that don't go up. And he kept on going and going and going, and he reached the peak of that bar." So the parents, in their language, spoke to the little frog and asked him. And then the parent smiled and turned to the other frogs and said, "Our baby frog is deaf. He cannot hear anything. And he thought, when all of you were shouting that don't go up, you will fall, he thought all of you are cheering him. So he kept on going up and he reached the peak." Is that how all of us are? So many times, because I am not able to do a particular thing, I try to limit my own children. Yeah? And it is like we've said earlier, you know, the subconscious mind is like that overprotective, overworried mother. Right? The intention, our intention, sir, is good. But sometimes, from where can we come from? We can only come from our own experience. Right? And our own experience can be limited. Right? So somebody like Elon Musk, if you take the story of Elon Musk, which is so amazing, he has built his own space company, which I think one private person, he is about to go in the space, not through NASA. Because he was not allowed in NASA, he created his own space company. And it is almost getting ready. I don't recall right now which year it is going to be launched, but soon, in next few years, the entire thing is ready. And the person is also finalized who is going to go. Right? So, we are limited only by our own beliefs and our own experiences. And our experiences, where do they come from? From our past. Right? Experience can never be in future. That we still have to experience. So, yes, we do have to teach them the values, the right kind of values, agreed. However, we have to really rethink. If our life is 100% perfect, if we think that I have achieved my potential, that means again I need to achieve more, right? But if I am a person who is reinventing myself every day, if I am a person who has that childlike quality, not childish, but that childlike curiosity about this world, then I am growing. Is that right?
Think.
Yeah.
I have to develop.
Yes.
He himself to think that
yes.
I have to develop.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
For developing, there are ways how to
yes.
find out the ways how to develop.
Absolutely. So once you have the passion, you will automatically find the ways.
But that individual to realize for himself.
See, if that individual is fired up enough by that particular dream, then that individual will find a way. Definitely will find a way. Just imagine, just observe the children in your own house, okay? So if they want to take you out for a movie, just see how they will take you out for a movie. They will come up with all creative ideas. If the children in our house, they want us to do something, you just observe their creativity one day as an observer. They will, with love, they will tell you how important it is for you, how much you will also enjoy, you know, and then they will take it. So children, if they really, really have to find something, only as parents or as elders, we can preserve their dreams. We can tell them, like, with freedom. I understand your point, sir. So, it is important to tell children that with freedom comes responsibility, the ability to respond. And one very beautiful thing I really learnt very recently is, what is the difference between reaction and response? So, I did this very beautiful program just last weekend. I was in Bangalore learning the Enlightened Warrior's Power, and our trainer Margene Holden. So she explained this very beautifully to us. What is the difference? I would like to ask you, what is the difference between a reaction and a response? Can you tell me? We will have to trust our own children, right? We will have to trust our own youngsters. We will have to empower them to make the right choices. So we need to give them the right values, the right value systems. And then we have to trust that then the decision that they will arrive at. And it is okay to make mistakes. Have we not made any mistakes in our lives? It is okay to make few mistakes. We are human beings, right? Nobody is born perfect, right? So, it is okay to make mistakes. Let them make their own mistakes also. So, I am going to give you the difference between the reaction and response. It is 3 seconds. Reaction is instant, without thinking. Response is taking those 3 seconds time and then responding. Right? So, when we are, if I am a person,
it is instant.
There is no gap. So it may be so many times no thinking, absolutely no thinking. And that 3 seconds you take the little time and then respond. Right? So if there is a snake, if you just go near a snake and put your foot, like if you threaten the snake, basically, if naturally if you're walking, the snake is not going to bite you. But if your vibration is threatening to the snake, the snake is going to bite you. If you have touched the snake in a threatening way and then you are scared, the snake will bite you. Definitely. That is the reaction. That is the reaction of the snake. It is not going to think. For why does it react? For survival. Right? And how many times do we retaliate like that? Even before somebody has said something, even we sometimes react like that and not respond. Many times with our own children, many times with our own selves. We feel, I want to do this. Immediately we talk ourselves down. Immediately, without a second, we laugh at ourselves. We are the most brutal to our own selves. And then what happens is, many times when we talk ourselves down, then we also feel that it is justified to talk others down. If I have not lived the life of my dreams, how can I allow you to live the life of your dreams? I sacrificed, so you must sacrifice. I did this, so you must also do that. There are so many times we do this with our own children. So many times we do this with so many people around us. So let us set ourselves free. And let us really find out what is my potential. So how do we really uncover our potential, or how do we discover our potential? So I'm going to give you one little story which again happened with me a couple of months back. So I was, again, for this particular one of the trainings, I was in Chennai. And there was this young couple we had our flights together, and around 5:20 we had the flight, and we had to reach the airport very early. So I think we reached the airport around 3:30 or something, we reached there. So our flight was at 5:20 in the morning, and I being from the earlier generation and not all that tech savvy, so I was just waiting in the waiting area and all that. So these youngsters, my friend, his name is Atul, and his wife, they were traveling with me. So they wanted to check where is the lounge and all. So Atul went and checked where the lounge was, and I went with both of them. I went to the lounge area, wherever it was, on the upper floor and all that. So I saw, I wasn't understanding anything what is happening, okay. So Atul gave his cards, his wife gave her cards, credit cards, debit cards, whatever. So they were checking. And then after a while, this lady, she said, there are only two points available. So, and then they said, we'll go down and sit. So till then I had not understood all this process. Till then I thought that sitting in the lounge was just sitting in a better sitting area and all that. And then I thought, when they said that let us all go down, that is when I realized that because of me, these two will also not get to sit in the lounge. And I felt really bad and very, very guilty. Now I had a couple of cards in my with me, okay. So there was one normal debit card that I was using, and my bank had issued me a new debit card with a chip or something. And I had luckily I had activated the PIN, but I wasn't yet using it. So once I use that card, my earlier card would be null and void. So I just asked that lady, I gave her my card and I asked her, do I have any points on this? Like, do I have lounge access with this? So she said, no, this card doesn't work. So then I gave her the second card. I said, is this valid? And she said, yes, it is valid. So you have a lounge access. And I was so relieved and so happy that, because of me, these two should not, be inconvenienced. That was what was in my heart. Now, this point behind telling this entire story is, see, I had the access to the lounge. I had the card in my purse. but I wasn't aware of what it could do. And apart from just comfortable seating, we also had amazing coffee and food and stuff inside. So, and it was very comfortable sitting there. You could actually sit comfortably, charge your mobiles, do whatever. So, yeah. Yes. And I, because of these guys, I discovered a new way of life, and I also came to know that through my card, I had an access to this place. And it made my trip to Bangalore this last weekend much more easier and comfortable. So what is this? When I was thinking about this, even today's topic, I thought about this topic and I sent this topic, I think around 1:30 a.m. or 2 a.m. when I was sitting in the lounge and really enjoying myself. And I was thinking of Atul, and I thought that had he not taken me to the lounge and had I not gone through this discomfort, I wouldn't even have brought out the card and asked whether I have it. So isn't it not like that hidden potential? I had the eligibility, I had the access, but I was not aware, and I was not willing. I was carrying that card with the chip for at least 4-5 months. I was afraid to change my old card to my new one. Yeah? I did not want to change. But only when I was faced with a situation, with an embarrassing situation, I brought it out. So many times, all of us, we are sitting with so much of treasure within us. In Buddhism, there is a parable of a jewel in your robe. You have a jewel inside your own robe and you are begging on the streets. All you could do was take out the jewel, sell it and live comfortably. And this is what I learned that day, right? And so the younger generation, they are not afraid of trying new things. They are not afraid of finding what their possibilities are. So there is so much for us to learn from them. And this is what I really learned that day, that this is our hidden potential, whether it is the usage of the card, knowing what you are eligible for on your card. And thanks to him, really, I had an amazing trip to Bangalore. I had late flights and I really spent some very good time sitting in the lounge with, you know, very peacefully. So it was, I would never have come across it had I not gone through the discomfort. Had I not given myself a chance, had I not opened my mouth that day, if I had just quietly with both of them, had I gone down and sat in the normal, I would have felt so guilty that because of me, these two cannot enter the lounge. I wouldn't have learnt a new thing. I wouldn't have learnt a new comfortable way of traveling. Right? I wouldn't have used the potential that I had within me, and unnecessarily I would have been in discomfort. I would have been uncomfortable. And this particular incident made me think about a lot of things. So can we, as people, every day, there is this ad, I don't remember again which drink it is, but dar ke aage jeet hai. It has become very, very famous. So whatever our fears, let us find them out. And let us also find out what is the purpose of our life. When we know the purpose of our life, we will be able to really find out our own potential. Because when I know in which direction I want to go, what is it that I want to do? What makes me happy? What is it that really makes me happy, makes me get up every morning, stay up in the night, late night, and still get up every morning and want to go out and work? What is it that makes me never think of retiring? What is retiring? What is retirement? It is shutting down of our systems. So let us never, never, ever even dream of retiring. Let us enjoy our life so much that every day we are raring to go. What new can I learn? What can I discover? What can I do? What new can I do? And let us find little joys around us. Like again, while I was in Bangalore, there was one very beautiful sight that I found out. I did not get the picture to even share with you, and I don't have it very clearly because my mobile's resolution is not very nice. So there is this place where we were having our workshop. So there's this Sheraton Hotel. In the same premises, they have an Orion Mall and some other complexes, some office complexes and some residential complex, all in one huge campus they have it. And while I was just walking down the driveway, where the exit and entry of the cars was, so there was a lot of honking, cars going by, and I was walking down the footpath to the entrance. And all of a sudden, I hear, this is in the evening about 6:30, nowadays it becomes dark by this time, and I just heard the chirping of birds. Along with all the honking, along with all the car noises and all that, there was this chirping of the birds, and I simply looked up. And I could not believe my eyes. It was such an amazing sight. The tree was full of parrots. The number almost equaled the number of leaves on those trees. It was such a delight. I actually went and showed it to so many of my friends. People who were staying in Bangalore had never noticed it. Because who looks up? And if you're going in the car, of course you're sitting in the car and going out. Right? So they needed a outsider like me. And I was very happy over there because I was in a new city, learning new experiences, and it was my dream city. I'd always wanted to go, and this was the first time I could go there. And that was such an amazing discovery. And it brought so much of joy for so many of us. Just that chirping of parrots, just that sight. In cities, where do we see this? So there is a potential of bringing and finding out joy in every moment of life. We just need to see it. Like when I was traveling right now in the local train, today I had three different age group of kids sitting next to me. It was such a joy watching them. There was this little baby who got in the train and promptly started crying. And then there was a little girl who was a little older than that baby. So she was so nicely trying to talk to him. What happened? Why are you crying? And this little kid, all of a sudden he stopped crying and he started smiling at that little girl. And then there was a girl who was a little older than them. All three of them, the way they were playing, and all from different stratas of society. All three of them. So initially the mothers were a little uncomfortable, but then eventually everybody coexisted in harmony. So such joy it brought me. Throughout the train journey today, I came smiling, looking at the wide, beautiful eyes of these children. So every day, every moment, if we see the beauty around us, we can find that joy within us. And if we can find that joy within us, we can truly find new ways and creative ways to do things. So my daughter is studying interior design, and on the very first day, I'm very fortunate that she is really studying what she wants to study. And the very first day, the principal of that college, he gave the children a very amazing advice, really good advice, really good piece of advice. And I have held on to it myself also. Because interior design is a creative field, he asked the children, all the children, to take care of their hobbies and grow their hobbies. They said, whatever it is that you like doing, please nurture your hobbies. And if you want help, from our side, we will also give you that support. Which is such an amazing thing for a principal of the college to say to the students. And they really live by it, which is another amazing thing. So there is a possibility. So if we are very clear about what we want, like my daughter was very clear, she wants to do interior design. I have no background about interior design, but because she was clear about it, the right kind of people came in my environment, and I thought of them. Like one of my school friends, I approached him. He is an architect, so I asked him. I took his advice, so he pointed us in that direction. He advised her about what to do and how to go about it. So when you are clear about what you want to do, when you are ready to discover your own potential, when you are ready to live your own dreams, the way will automatically unfold without doubt. The only thing is that we need to believe. Do I give myself the permission to live my life to the fullest? It is only about me giving permission to myself and then doing whatever it takes. So if we take an example of an acorn, or let us take an example of an apple seed, okay? So if there is an apple seed, the apple seed has a potential to grow into an apple tree. But if it just has the potential and it sits on the table, is it ever going to grow in an apple tree? It needs to be sown, it needs to be nurtured, right? And then it will grow into an apple tree, which will in turn give so many more seeds. And each of us has that potential. There are so many people we come across who say, oh, I would have become this person. I had the potential of becoming this person. Like, okay, I'll make a little confession myself. So again, another person, I did not go up to her and take a selfie or something, because she was at quite a distance, and by the time I recognized her, she had walked quite a distance. So, and I had behaved myself. I really wish I had not behaved myself. I would have just, you know, lived in the moment. So Barkhadat, I ran into Barkhadat on the airport, Bangalore airport, and I really admire her more because she is the one who interviewed Oprah Winfrey when Oprah Winfrey was in India. And Oprah is my idol. So I always used to say this, that if I had done journalism instead of engineering, instead of Barkhadat, it would have been me. So how many times do we encounter people like this? Or how many times do we say this? Like I am guilty of saying this, that had I done journalism, instead of Barkhadat, it would have been Rohini, not Barkha. Right? So many times we think that, okay, I have the potential of doing this. If I had got this chance, no, then I would have been here. So many times are we guilty of doing this, right? But from whatever chance we have we done? Or what do we do? And do we even take an effort or a step towards the chance?
Get into action.
If until and unless we take action, how are we ever going to realize our own dreams? How are we ever going to even find our own potential? How do I know what I'm capable of doing? Unless and until I get out of my comfort zone, get out of my home, go out and do something which I'm afraid of doing. Right? Something we all really need to ponder over. And there's one very beautiful thing which I got from Barbara Oakley. Now this is a lady who never liked math, and who was never good at maths. Later on she became an engineer, and today she says that every day do a little bit of math, just to increase your own capability. To increase your own capacity. And what she said is, don't just follow your passion, broaden that passion. I really like this line very much. Don't just follow your passion, broaden that passion. You never know what is available, because what I know as my passion today will be again limited only by my own knowledge and by my own experiences. How will I discover something new until and unless I try on something new, I would just not. And for that I really need to come out of my own comfort zone, right? So yeah, so again, to quote Dr. Miles Monroe, he says that when you find your purpose, you will automatically find your potential. And how do we find this purpose? That can be another topic for another day, but there is one very simple thing that one we can really start doing. How do I find my purpose? What is it that makes me really, really happy? Let us sit down, and I cannot stress more about the benefits of meditation. Because what is meditation? Meditation is that act of quieting our mind, quieting that chatter in our mind, which is continuously over there. So when we practice meditation, we quieten that chatter in our mind, and then maybe we can reach out to our subconscious mind, which has all the resources that we ever need for ourselves. Because from the day that we were born, our mind has absorbed everything like a sponge. Everything is stored over there. When we recall, so many times it happens, right? We don't remember somebody's names. What is this person's name? I know. I just know. I have it right in front. I just know. I'm not getting. What is the name? Think, how many times do we do that? And when does the name come to us? When we are sitting relaxed, when we are doing something, actually not doing something, we are just sitting there and, oh, this was the name of that person. Why did that happen? Because our mind was quiet. So the moment we ask any question to our own subconscious mind, the subconscious mind is willing to answer. Our subconscious mind is a great servant, but a very bad master. So,
I sit into a meditation.
Yes.
Next visit, another thought comes in and disturbs in meditation.
Yes. It does.
Keeping mind in a standstill position is a very difficult thing.
It is. It is. That's why it is called the monkey mind, which keeps on chattering all the time. So there's one very beautiful
another thought comes, yeah. Then again I try.
Yes. So when you really try to focus on your own breath, you know, the mind will go there. The mind will go here and there, because that is the job of the mind, to chatter, 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 chatter all the time. Right? So what you can do during that time is bring your focus again on your breath. You know, the more we focus on our breath, just imagine when we are angry, just try to observe how we are breathing. When we are really angry, we have very short and shallow breaths, right? The breath is like, it's a very, as if we are, we breathe as if we are running a marathon. So it's, because again, when we are angry, the whole system, the whole body is there all ready to fight in that angry mode, right? But if we take one moment and just realize those 3 seconds, that response, yeah. So just if we just take 1 second and remind ourselves, make it a habit, first go, it will never happen. We will keep on have to practicing it, right? But even in that anger, even for a second, if we just observe our breath, immediately the breath will start getting normal. And when the breath starts getting normal, we are in the position to respond and not react. So, observing our breath.
No, concentrate on any object or only no
object? If you see, there are many types of meditations. Now, the simplest one, if you want to concentrate on an object, go ahead by all means. There are sometimes one can concentrate on the sound of the AC or the sound of the fan or something, you know, just to hook your mind somewhere. That is just a hook. So you can decide what hook you want to, or the simplest one is your own breath.
Yes.
Yeah. How, just observe your own breath. How is it that you're breathing in? How are you breathing out? The mind will wander. Just gently bring it back.
Again to bring there. Once it reaches, again bring to deep.
Just try to breathe, not even deep breathing. Simply observe your breath to begin with. If that is the beginning of meditation, the simplest way is to focus on your breath. That's it. Otherwise, the newest and the latest version of meditation, which is even simpler, is to let somebody else do the speaking. So I personally, I am a big fan of all the guided meditations available on the YouTube. So just listen to that and see what resonates with you. Like, there are some voices I don't like, some voices I like, some kind of music I don't enjoy, some kind of music I enjoy. And again, it all depends upon my mood also. So sometimes when I'm not able to do meditation on my own, when my mind is wandering too much, there is too much happening in my mind, these guided meditations always help me to bring myself to center. No need at all. Meditation, just be. Just be. Yeah, just be. And that too, don't even, just deep, do the deep breathing initially maybe for a while. But try some moments of silence where you are just being. Just observing. Just being that observer of your own breath. To begin with. Otherwise, there are so many meditation techniques one can go and learn. One of them is Vipassana, and so many other meditation techniques everybody is, many people are teaching also, and many forms of meditation actually. So see what resonates with you, whatever it is that you are able to do. But the simplest one, for which we don't need anybody else's help or anything, is simply our own breath, observing our own breath. Yeah, so that is one thing. When we really quieten, start having those moments of quiet, we also start getting downloads of what we can do. That is where we will come to know what it is that I want to do. That is where you might just find your purpose. So when you ask your own mind, what is the purpose of my life? The mind will answer. Like you asked for a name and the mind gave you the name. When you ask, what is the purpose of my life? The mind will tell you the purpose of your life. We just need to listen, and then we need to act upon it. Unless and until we act upon it, we won't be able to do anything. Right?
What is that inner voice that gives the answer?
The inner voice, again, you will have to check what that inner voice is coming from. Okay, because there could be a little confusion between the inner voice. When your inner voice makes you happy, really joyful and excited, that is your true inner voice. If that inner voice is the voice telling you, don't do this, if you do this, you will fall, that is the overcaring subconscious mind trying to warn you and pull you back. So we are the judge, and our own physique, our own body will answer. Our own intuition, we will be able to find the answer. Our body will tell us many a times. Right? So, I wish you all the best on the journey of finding your own potential. Couple of things before I leave, before we conclude. So, the greatest enemy of our progress is our last success. This is one line I really liked. So, the greatest enemy of our progress is our last success. So, if we were successful, we think, okay, now I am successful, now I am done, I have arrived. And that is where we put a full stop to our potential.
Yes. You're not trying for.
Yeah. So you're not trying for anything more. And the quote that I would like to leave you with today is, the ability to participate in miracles, true miracles in your life, happens when you open your mind to limitless potential. This is from Dr. Wayne W. Dyer. So let us truly open our minds to limitless potential and do our best and find out what is it that we are capable of doing. Thank you.